Ancient life is preserved as fossils at Wasson Bluff in the sedimentary rocks of the early Jurassic period. There are 200-million-year-old fishes, including sharks, prosauropod dinosaur remains, reptiles, and ancestors of the mammals. The fossils here all represent survivors from the mass extinction event at the end of the Triassic period that wiped out over 40% of life on Earth. Let's take a look.
I was mostly interested in the geology. This is why I went there. I went there because there was literature that said there were lava flows, and lava flows can be dated with radioactive decay methods. So it was a difficult trip, that particular visit, because wading down a river, it was not comfortable. I was up to, you know, often up to my waist, but that was the only way you could travel because the brush was too dense to walk through. So I waded down the river and then turned onto the beach. This is the trip up to Nova Scotia that I found the first dinosaurs in Nova Scotia, in Eastern Canada, in fact. I walked down a spot called Moose River from the main road in near Parsboro. So I was there for the geology. I was there to look at the rocks. I always had an eye out for fossils. And the first ones were in lake deposits, which I recognized as such. And there were some fossil fish scraps. I'd found many fossil fish by that time in my life. So it was not that shocking or unusual. And then I walked a little bit further down the beach. And I noticed these orange, tan orange sands, and the sandstones had these big sloping surfaces in it that I recognized as characteristic of dune sands. Came across this one spot where there were these white things on the ground. So the fragments that I found were very angular, and this was the discovery bone found in 1976, and they excavated a number of skeletons from there. And it kind of unfolded gradually, our realization that these were really important pieces.
Paul Olsen and Donald Baird and Jack Horner, that early Princeton University trips coming up in the early 70s really changed the perspective of Wasson's Bluff.
A couple days later, we went, all three of us were there, and we sieved the material around the gravel and things, the beach gravel and sand around that area to try to see if we could find more fragments. And we did. We also found dinosaur footprints. And those were also the first dinosaur footprints from Atlantic Canada.
Paul Olsen had found some bones in the sort of sandy facies at Wasson Bluff. And we were out there to look for that. And we found additional material, including that beautiful little skull that is now at the Fundy Geological Museum of Plevosaurus, which we named after Donald Baird, who had done the pioneering work in the Fundy Basin in Triassic. I was part of the team that went out first in 1984, and then we had a really good summer in 1985, where we discovered that there were like literally thousands and thousands of bones. Some of the things that came out of these crack fillings turned out to be Trithelodontids, and Trithelodontids are among the closest relatives to actual mammals.
So we started to prepare the dinosaur that was collected in 1994 up at the Fundy Geological Museum. There was multiple blocks that were collected, so my job was to chip away the sandstone to expose the dinosaur bones. And we had a pretty well complete specimen, except it was missing its skulls.
That wasn't bluff, that there were these bones of dinosaurs, which unfortunately, even though they're really interesting, that tectonically so deformed, because this was sort of a very active seismic zone of the basin, that it's very difficult to figure out what's going on there. The assumption has always been that they were similar to the what's called sauropodomorph dinosaurs, which is a group related to the big sauropods, like the brontosaurus and diplodocus and so on. But that these animals were related to ones that had been found in the 19th century already in the Connecticut area.
The fossils at Wasson Bluff are so important because they date from right after this mass extinction, right when the dinosaurs were massively blooming and taking over.
There's more to find. There's theropod dinosaurs to find. There's pterosaurs to find. We need to find some nests. So we need to find more of the small vertebrates, I think would be good too.
What makes Wasson Bluff so important is the variety of fossils and the environments that they are found. In this painting, you can see the major fossils that have been found here, from these semi-anotus fish and ancient sharks, all the way to the famous Prosauropod dinosaurs. Just as important are the smaller animals, such as this crocodile-like Protosuchus, the sphenodonts, and lastly, the stem mammal Trithelodontids. These are just some of the amazing discoveries made at this one location. As the tides of the Bay of Fundy erode the cliffs, there will be more discoveries to be made in the future. If we now take this painting and rotate it, we can match it up to the cliff face, and you can see how some of these environments look today. We also start to get an appreciation of how geologists look at the rocks and are able to tell us amazing stories of the past.
So suddenly we had this incredible collection of things in well-dated rocks, because the salts we can do radiometric dating on. So we had a really nice datum point there where we could say this happened and then this happened within a span of about 100,000 years. And that's given that these are rocks that are over 200 million years old. That's fantastic. You know, I have collected fossils basically all over the world, but Nova Scotia is and remains my favorite place to look for fossils.
And it is such an amazing place with the tides and the scenery. It's just been an important place for a long time.
This spot means a lot to me. I mean, I have a lot of my history invested in it. It's a very important scientific site. You know, it's really meant a lot.